Today we're looking at the PICC line assessment, those things that you need to be looking at when you first look at your patient at the beginning of your shift to make sure you know that that PICC line is safe for your patient. Let's get started. Welcome back. My name is Tammy and this is Nurse Minder, and on this channel we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released.
Here we have an example of a peripherally inserted catheter, central catheter, often called the PICC line. In our morning assessments, one of the first things we want to do is just to look at the site itself and visually inspect it. We're looking for any redness or swelling. We're going to ask the patient if they're having any pain or decreased mobility in that arm. Next, we're going to move on to looking at the dressing. We want to make sure that the dressing is still secure, dry, and intact. And you want to check the date to make sure that it's within the parameters of your facility. Moving on to the clamp, we want to make sure that it in fact is locked if not in use, and that we have a neutral connector on our tip. If, for some reason, our neutral connector were to come off, and our lock was not secure, our patient would exsanguinate. I'm just going to quickly reset my PICC line here. Some of the data we need to complete our assessment would come on a patient information document, such as this PICC insertion record. Now this is a sample and these numbers will not match what we're going to find in our assessment, but what I want you to locate are the internal external lengths as well as the arm circumference. We're going to be assessing that at the bedside. One of the tools we need to complete our assessments is a measuring tape. We'll start with the arm circumference. Place your tape around the arm so that it crosses over at the insertion site. Take the measurement and note if there's any differences. So here we have 33 centimeters. If we were to use the numbers from my sample here, we were expecting to find 25 centimeters. That would mean there's significant swelling in this arm since the insertion of the PICC line. As a result of this, your actions will be based on agency policy and may include stopping the infusion, consulting the PICC nurse, and notifying the doctor. We still have two more measurements to confirm, and that would be the internal and external length. You may find that there are notches and numbers on your line, but if you can't read them, you're going to use your measuring tape again to go from insertion site to the straightest line you can make down to the catheter hub. Here we're at 13 centimeters. Again, when I compare that to my document, if the original external length was only 5 centimeters, this line has been dislodged, and again, your actions will depend on your agency policy.
Now that you know your PICC line is safe for patient use, you can carry on with your other tasks for the day. This might include checking patency, doing a medication admin, or completing a dressing change. Until next time, make it a great day.